give you heavier jet.
Yep, it's cool. It's cool. Celtics, this time for the playoffs.
And the Cavaliers come all the way back and take out the Celtics.
This is for the win.
Let's go! Jacob!
It's us versus everyone. That's the mindset we have. It's the mindset we got to keep. Been knocked down a few times this season. But yeah, we keep getting up and fighting. That's what we're going to continue to do.
As the season has progressed, we've gotten better. We've established who we are, what we're about.
I never lost faith, never lost hope. And I think we still have a lot of room to grow.
That's gonna do it for the NBA regular season, and your Boston Celtics are the number 2 seed in the Eastern Conference.
We've come a long way, but
we're just getting started.
In this city, so we want
playoffs presented by Arbella and Quantum. And today's game one between the Brooklyn Nets and the Boston Celtics.
Nation's colors. Today, the colors are being presented by the Revere High School's Army Junior ROTC program. And now, for the singing of our national anthem, please welcome top Billboard charting indie recording artist, most known as NBC's The Voice Season 3 finalist, Michelle Brooks Thompson.
Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? Through the perilous.
Come on, Tatum, all the way. I thought you were going to have it.
Oh.
And the other way. That's his second.
Personal foul. The first quarter, fans.
Right in the second. Let's go, Tatum. Let's get going. Attack it. I like that. Tatum, take over. There you go. Thank you. I need you to get going. Or Brown, one of the two. Yeah.
Celtics 61 and the Brooklyn Nets 60.
All right, second half begins. Here we go. Back him up, back him up, back him up. Nice. Nice. Brown, we gotta capitalize on those.
Go Celtics!
Take it to the rim. Good board. That is, that's Brown's third.
Brooklyn foul is on number one, Bruce Brown. That's his.
What a great down!
Irene Irving.
Warren, no. 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 Jaylen, pass the ball.
Take it. Yes.
Oh. Yep. Red fans, sit out.
Just reflect on some of the highlights that I left in TD Garden that they could replay.
Oh, you want everybody, including Celtic fans, to just get over it, your time in Boston, and you actually want technically a video tribute because you said a highlights from your time at the Garden, meeting with the Celtics. Really? Huh. You know what we're going to do? You know what we're going to do, Kyrie? We all know what you did in Boston, promising fans that you'd resign, quitting on the team, leaving us after you quit on us, so on and so forth, literally planning on leaving the Celtics when you said two max slots to Kevin Durant. So you know what we're going to do, Kyrie? We're going to literally show why that will never, ever happen, because you always put another log under the fire every time you come back here in Boston.
I mean, it's not my first time being an opponent in Boston. So, you know, I'm just looking forward to competing with my teammates. And, you know, hopefully we could just keep it strictly basketball. You know, hopefully we could just keep it strictly basketball.
You know, hopefully we could just keep it strictly basketball.
I don't know what it's going to be like, but it's the same energy they have for me, and I'm going to have the same energy for them. And it's not every fan. I don't want to attack every fan, every Boston fan, but, you know, when people start yelling pussy and bitch and fuck you and all this stuff, it's but so much you can take as a competitor. And, you know, we're the ones expected to be docile and be humble and take a humble approach. Nah, fuck, that's the playoffs. This is what it is. You know, I know what to expect in here, and it's the same energy I'm giving back to them. It is what it is. I'm not really focused on it. It's fun. You know what I'm saying? Like again, this, where I'm from, I've dealt with so much. So coming in here, you relish it as a competitor. And this is, you know, I'm going to keep repeating myself when I say again, but this isn't my first time in TD Garden. So what you guys saw and what you guys think is as entertainment, or the fans think is entertainment, all is fair in competition. You know, so if somebody's going to call me out of my name, I'm going to look at them straight in the eye and see if they really about it. Most of the time, they're not.
Kyrie, to that point, do you feel like the hostility that you get still?
Let's not focus on this. Like, ask me questions about the game. Like, it's not about the fans. The fans aren't playing.
From a basketball standpoint,
yeah.
Do you feel like the hostility you get?
There's no hostility, bro. It's basketball.
Well, you were flicking some people off. I'd say that's some hostility.
From what? What point? Are you guessing that that's hostility? Or, like, hostility for me is, like, growing up.
Well, we've never seen that from you this season, where you are running down the floor, flicking people off.
This is the first time you actually caught it. Because it's a big-time game. I respond in different ways. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to focus on that. If you want to ask me questions about the fans, go ask them. Go on the street and ask them questions. Right?
But I'm asking from your perspective, from basketball perspective, do you feel like the hostility that you get?
It's not hostility, fans, bro.
Do you feel like the energy you get from fans in this building brings out the best from you?
Embrace it. Embrace it. It's the dark side. Embrace it.
Irving fires away. Got it. A two-pointer for
defense. A better offense. Knockdown shot in the corner, and then
not playing part-time, now full-time. He is one of the most electrifying players in the game. Another outside.
Kyrie back in Boston, part two.
You're gonna have to move out of the way, please.
Embrace it. Embrace it.
There's no belligerence or any racism going on, subtle racism and people yelling shit from the crowd. But even if it is, it's part of the nature of the game, and we're just going to focus on what we can control.
Is it something you've experienced in Boston before?
I'm not the only one that could attest to this, but it's just, you know, it is what it is.
No, I think it's going to be like that. Well, I know it's going to be like that for the rest of my career coming in here. So, you know, it's like the scoring girlfriend, you know, just wants an explanation on why I left, but still hoping for, you know, a text back. And I'm just like, yeah, it's fun while it lasted.
So, yeah, there you go, Kyrie. It's a little something for you to think about there.
Unreal. Let's go!